Welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new here. Today's video is a special one. This is something that I've been spending a lot of time thinking about, figuring out exactly how I want to go about sharing the information with you guys. But I know that there are a lot of people out there that struggle on freestyle. As you know, I did film a video not too long ago. I will put it up here in the iCards, talking about help, I'm not losing weight on WW Freestyle. Gave you tips, tricks, suggestions on things that may help you along your WW Freestyle journey. But I'm noticing a lot of YouTubers are switching to the old WW plans, everything from Classic to Points Plus to Smart Points, and veering away from Freestyle. And I hate to see that happen. As you know, Weight Watchers or WW spends a lot of time and money doing scientific research, figuring out what is the best plan for the population, the majority of the population, to be successful in their weight loss. So it saddens me to see that so many people are not successful on Freestyle, and so many people have decided to completely switch programs. So I am here today to let you know that yes, no matter what, you can be successful on Freestyle. And I'm here to offer you my top 5 tips on exactly how to be successful on Freestyle. So if you're on the fence of switching programs, or you're wondering, what am I doing wrong, or what can I do? What are the tips to be successful on Freestyle? Then just stay tuned, because I'm gonna share my top 5 with you. So number 5 tip to be successful on WW Freestyle: don't be scared to use your weeklies. A lot of people say, I don't lose weight if I use my weeklies. I don't lose weight if I eat all my points every day. Weeklies are there for a reason. They're there to help you, one, stay within your suggested caloric intake for the week, and two, they are there to allow you freedom and allow you the option to eat foods that you wanna eat. A lot of us, if you take away things from us or tell us we can't have things, we are not successful. You cannot take something away from me or tell me I can never have bread, or I can never have sugar or red meat, and expect me to be able to sustain that and do that for life. So that is why Weight Watchers or WW gives us weeklies. It's so we can indulge in some of those foods that we really enjoy. Maybe we want to have a beer with dinner on a Friday night. Or maybe we're going to a birthday party and we don't want to be the only one not having cake. That is what the flexibility of your weekly points are for. They are there for you to use. It does not hinder your weight loss. If you stay within your daily points, you stay within your weekly points, you will lose weight. Guaranteed, I promise you, on WW Freestyle. It's when you go above and beyond your weekly points. It's when you have several splurge or cheat days in a week. That's when you won't see a drop on the scale. And that's gonna happen on whatever program you follow. Points Plus, Smart Points, Classic Points. If you go above and beyond and eat more than your body needs in a week, you're not gonna lose weight. You're gonna gain weight. You're gonna maintain your weight. So on Freestyle, use your weekly points. Now, if you don't use all of your daily points, so let's say that you maybe eat extra 0-point foods in a day, or you're just not hungry, WW allows you to roll over 4 daily smart points that will then move into your weekly points. So if you know that you have a splurge coming up later in the week, or you know you're gonna have a really high point day, you can roll over 4 points on a daily basis and eat your weeklies and still lose weight. So you don't have to deprive yourself. You don't have to be the one at the party who doesn't eat the cake. Just plan ahead, plan accordingly, and do not be afraid to use your weekly points. My number 4 tip: track. Track, track, be a tracking fool. Make sure that you are tracking everything that enters your mouth. I don't know if you have heard of the term BLTs, but that's an older WW or Weight Watcher term, and it stands for bites, licks, and tastes. So when you're cooking dinner and you take a bite of the rice that you just cooked, or you're baking WW-friendly sweet treats and you lick the spoon, all of those add up. All of those count as points. So the more BLTs or bites, licks, and tastes that you take throughout the week, you would be shocked how quickly you can go over both your daily and your weekly smart points by doing those types of things. So track everything. Use the WW app to track your food. You can enter the nutritional information if you can't find the food in the search field. You can create recipes. I do have a video that I showed you how to use the recipe builder, so I will link that down in the description box below. But there are so many options for you to track your food in the app. Now, if you are not proficient in the app, or you don't have a smartphone or a computer, paper track. Do the old school program back in the early 2000s where you tracked on paper. No matter what you do, just track. You can see what you're eating. You can see how much you're eating. You can see when you're way under your smart points or way over your daily points. Track, track, and track. Another thing on the Weight Watchers app that a lot of people aren't aware of is that it does track your calories. So for example, if I go into the WW app and I track a hard-boiled egg, it's going to tell me that it's 0 points, but when I go to add it to my daily tracker, it's going to show me the macros. It shows me the calories. Be aware of calories. A lot of you say, I eat way too little on WW Freestyle. Okay, that's a possibility. So my suggestion would be to up your 0 point foods. Eat some more fruits and vegetables. Have a hard-boiled egg if you're feeling a little bit hungry between meals. But watch on your WW app your calories. Make sure you're within your healthy eating range of calories as well. And again, if you're too low, add some 0 point foods. If you're too high, maybe take a look at your 0 point foods and decrease the amount that you're eating in a day. Fruits have calories. 0 point chicken has calories. Beans have calories. So watch that in the WW app to make sure that you're not too high in calories or too low in calories. Both of those things can put a huge impact on your weight loss. It can make it so you don't lose weight if you eat too little. It can make you so you don't lose weight, obviously, if you consume more calories in a given day that you're burning. So just track your food, and you may be surprised how much or too little you're eating on Freestyle. My third tip for you, weigh yourself on a regular basis. I know that there are a lot of people out there that are boycotting the scale, no more scale. I don't know that that's necessarily a good idea. I know that you can see the difference in your weight fluctuation in your clothes, but sometimes having that number for accountability is huge in staying on track. I suggest that you attend a workshop. WW workshops are amazing. There is no way that I would not be a workshop member of WW. I get so much inspiration from my workshop. I learn so much. Like I've told you in the past, most of the time when I go to my workshop, I come away with something that inspires me and motivates me for the week. Plus, there are times when you need the workshop, and there's times when the workshop needs you. There's times when it needs you to come in and share your experiences, your highs, your lows on WW. I strongly suggest attending a workshop. I know that that's not always in your budget, so a lot of people will do online. I think that's phenomenal as well. Of course, you do miss out a little bit on the workshop, but I do a weekly recap of the workshop topic every week on Friday. I have countless videos on my channel of that. You can also chat 24/7 with a coach and ask your questions. If you don't attend a workshop and you have WW questions, the coach feature is amazing, and it's free to you as a WW member. So either weigh yourself at a workshop or weigh yourself online, or maybe keep a paper log of your weight. If you're not somebody that can afford to attend or even sign up at all with WW, keep a paper tracker, have a calendar, have a weight chart, have something that shows you your weight. But I recommend that you at least weigh in once a week, maybe once every 2 weeks. But I think stepping on the scale is huge for accountability. You can see when your weight is creeping up, especially those of you on Lifetime. You can see when you're approaching the 2 pounds above your goal weight. You don't want to pay to go to your workshop. It just helps keep you accountable. And I think that knowing where you are in your weight is huge in either maintaining or losing weight. So that's just my opinion. For me, I know that having to step on the scale in front of someone else at a workshop is huge motivation for me to stay on track. My number two tip for you is to plan ahead. There is nothing worse than getting to work or getting to a social event or going out to run errands and not having planned ahead. Now you don't have food, you don't know what you're gonna eat, you're gonna go to the quickest fast food restaurant so that you can just shovel some food in your face, and you really can easily go off track all the time without planning ahead. Now you know that this girl right here loves her some meal prep. I have dozens of meal prep videos on my channel. Make sure that you watch those. It'll give you recipes, step-by-step instructions. I always link the recipe down in the description box below. And I will let you know as well if I've made any modifications to the recipe. So check those out. Check out those meal prep videos. I highly encourage you to meal prep. Now, if you don't have time to make all of your breakfasts and lunches for the week, that's okay. If you don't want to eat the same thing all week long, that's okay. Do a buffet style meal prep. If you're not familiar with what that is, basically you're going to prep a lot of different foods, and then each day you will take your meals out of those prepped foods. So you are eating something different every single day. I'm okay eating the same breakfast and lunch all week. I change up my snacks. I change up my dinners. So I'm okay with the traditional meal prep, and it keeps me on track. When I'm starving at work, I don't have temptations to eat other food. And if you don't know, my work, we can eat for free. So we can go into the dining hall at the university and have as much of whatever foods we want. So I know myself, and I know that if I didn't plan ahead, and if I didn't have a breakfast, a lunch, and snacks on hand, this girl would be heading to the dining hall, and I can guarantee you, I wouldn't be making good choices. I wouldn't be eating salad. I'd be having the cookies. I would have pizza, mac and cheese, burgers. That's what I would do. So for me, planning is huge. And I know for a lot of you, you've said you have saved my WW journey with your meal prep videos, because it's the only way that I stay on track throughout the week. So no matter what you do, I think planning ahead is huge. Now, you can also plan out your meals for the week. And you know, I am in love with my Curiel meal planner. I seriously don't know what I would do without this. This is the one thing that helps me plan. I plan my meals, I plan my meal prep, I plan my grocery list, I plan gatherings. In fact, we are hosting Easter dinner at my house. So in my Curiel meal planner, there is a tab to plan your gatherings. So I suggest getting a meal planner. It will definitely help you plan a little bit better. I do have a 10% off discount code for Curiel. I'll put it here on the screen. And there is a direct link to her website down in the description box below. In my opinion, the Curiel meal planner is the most comprehensive, best quality, for the price meal planner on the market. So I highly suggest that you pick up Curiel and that you definitely plan ahead. Also, if you're going to run some errands, there's nothing wrong with throwing some snacks in your purse. I keep stuff in my car, you guys. I have little individual bags of Pop Chips. I have Built Bars. I have Quest Bars. I have things just readily available to me at all times. So if I am out and about or I'm doing something around the house and I'm hungry, I have pre-planned, pre-prepped snacks available. I'm telling you, in my opinion, it is one of the top ways to stay on track and be successful on freestyle. Always plan ahead, prep your meals, and be prepared. And my number one tip for you is something that I have learned along my WW freestyle journey that has helped me be successful. I also talked a little bit about this in my Help I'm Not Losing Weight on WW Freestyle video that I did post up in the iCards earlier in this video, and that is my 2-2-1 method. And that is something that I've implemented in my journey, and I'm telling you, it works. So one of the biggest complaints on WW Freestyle is the 0-point foods. 0-point foods does not mean 0-point calories. All food has calories. The only thing in this world that does not have calories is water. Any food that you're going to consume, whether it's a stem of broccoli, a potato chip, a piece of chicken, a scoop of fat-free refried beans, all has calories. So I think that a lot of people overindulge in the 0-point foods. You don't have to track them necessarily, so you don't even know how many calories you're consuming of 0-point foods in a day. So my 2-2-1 method goes a little bit like this. I allow myself 2 0-point proteins per day. So if I have eggs for breakfast, that's that's 1 0-point protein. If I have chicken somewhere, somehow in my lunch, so maybe I'm having a chicken sandwich or a breast of chicken, that is my second 0-point protein for the day. So that means that I am no longer allowed to track any more proteins as 0 points. So for dinner, I either need to have a non-0-point protein, such as lean ground beef or red meat or pork, or if I do choose to have chicken for dinner, I have to track it. And a lot of you, I mean, hundreds of you have asked me in my last Help I'm Not Losing Weight video, how the heck do you track 0-point foods? If I type chicken in the WW app, it tells me it's 0 points. Yes, it does. So in order to track it, what you have to do is enter the nutritional information. Weigh out that chicken, enter the calories, enter the saturated fat, the protein and the sugar. It will give you a points value. Okay, so it's gonna pop up a points value solely based on the nutritional information that you entered. That is what I track. So if I have 3 ounces of chicken, and when I enter that into the nutritional calculator and it tells me that's 3 points, I track 3 points. That way I'm not overindulging in the 0-point proteins. It works for me. I know myself, I would eat chicken for every meal to save points for other things if I didn't do the 2 0-point proteins per day without tracking method. Also, I only allow myself 2 fruits per day. So if I choose to have a fruit with breakfast and a fruit with lunch, that's it. No more fruit that day. I typically always have a fruit with breakfast, and I either have a fruit with my morning snack or with my lunch. So if I choose to have a fruit before dinner or as part of my dessert, I track it. Same method. I enter the nutritional facts into the calculator and I track whatever points it populates. That way I am not overindulging on fruit. Fruit has calories. Fruit has naturally occurring sugar. So fruit can definitely, in my opinion, stunt your weight loss. I've seen it happen to myself. So I make sure that I don't indulge in more than 2 fruits per day. And I don't allow more than 1 0-point starch a day. So if I choose to have corn or peas with the meal, that's my 0-point starch. If I choose to have black beans, kidney beans, cannellini beans, whatever, as part of my meal, that's my 1 0-point starch. Again, any other beans or starchy 0-point food that I eat throughout the day, the information goes into the calculator and the points are tracked. That way I stay within my 2-2-1 method, 2 0-point proteins, 2 0-point fruits, and 1 0-point starch. That way I don't overindulge. I'm not eating more 0-point foods. I'm not eating a slew of 0-point foods and then stocking up on Doritos. You're not gonna lose weight if you do that, you guys, because those 0-point foods, like I said, still have calories. So that is my 2-2-1 method. That is my number one tip on how to be successful on WW Freestyle. Thank you so much for watching today's video with my top 5 tips on how to be successful following the WW Freestyle program. I know it can be done. There are countless WW members who have lost hundreds of pounds on Freestyle. My really good friend Amy from my workshop, she's lost over 100 pounds solely on Freestyle. The program works if you work the program. So I hope that these 5 tips that I shared with you help you be a little bit more successful on Freestyle. I think the program is fabulous. And like I mentioned, there is years of scientific study behind this program showing that it works for the population. So stick with Freestyle, incorporate these 5 tips, and I hope that it helps you be a little bit more successful. So if you're new to my channel, I'd like to welcome you. Make sure that you subscribe. Hit the little notification bell. That way you'll get notified every time I upload a new video. I upload most days of the week, and my videos are 99.9% WW content. So I'm here to help you be successful on your journey, and I appreciate you helping me be accountable on mine. Make sure that you give this video a thumbs up. Comment below. Let me know if any of the tips I shared with you are something new to you, and if you plan to incorporate them into your Freestyle journey. And of course, thank you again so much for watching. I love each and every one of you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.